Hello dear friends, how are you? I hope you all are safe. Now see here, in coordination compounds, we are discussing today isomerism in coordination compound. Okay? Isomerism in coordination compound. So for this isomerism, you need to know from our first onwards. Means whatever we saw in first, our ligands, okay? In that we saw the types of ligands, monodentate, bidentate or didentate, tridentate, tetradentates, polydentates, okay? So here this thing you must know, whatever ligands, ambidentate ligands, chelating ligands, okay? You know this all, and I know you practice of this also, okay? You revise that all contained, okay? So see here, isomerism. So as you know, this thing you already discussed, isomerism in organic chemistry. There is a separate part regarding your isomerism. Okay. Now see here, what will be the definition? So as you know, so again we will revise. Compounds having same molecular formula but different. See here, the compounds having same molecular formula but different, yes, but different properties, formula, but what beta, but different, yes, different properties. Okay, so these are what definitions regarding your isomerism. And we call it as isomers, and phenomenon is called as what? Isomerism. Okay. So we will classify here whatever our isomerism like this. Say isomerism. Here mainly they are classified into two class, that is structural isomerism. Okay. What beta? Structural isomerism. And here, yes, stereo isomerism. Okay, so here also some types in structural isomerism that we will discuss now one by one. And in stereo isomerism there are two types. Okay, say here, first one is geometrical isomerism. Say beta, geometrical, yes, geometrical isomerism. And here what? Yes, optical isomerism. Okay, isomerism what beta? Yes, structural isomerism, stereo isomerism, in that geometrical and optical isomerism. So we will start here what? Structural isomerism. Regarding what beta? Structural isomerism. So you can write, okay, you have to concentrate on it, is very much important regarding your exam. Okay, so see here, we will write here what? Structural isomerism. See, structural isomerism. So see here, what will happen in structural isomerism? Okay, so in structural isomerism we will see first, okay, that is ionization. What be the ionization isomerism? See what will happen, we have to write first definition here. These isomers differ in, these isomers differ in number and types of ions produced in producing solution. Okay. Now suppose here we will take as an example, say there are two isomers of the compounds having formula. So say here we will discuss correctly, neatly one example here. Then you will come to know how we can recognize ionization isomerism. Okay, ionization isomer. So say we will take here one as an example. Okay, so say it is one of the coordination compound we will discuss, that is CONH3 5 BrSO4. So see here what will happen here, in that you will get one of the compound, you will get red violet color and forms a precipitate with BrCl2. Okay, one of the isomer, what was the color of that? Violet. And they will form precipitate with, they will form precipitate with your BrCl2. Okay, they are giving here, okay, they are giving here precipitate of BrCl2, means it conclude that out of the coordination sphere it must contain what? SO4, that is your sulfate ion. Okay, now suppose if you are taking second one, so in second case what will happen? You will get red color. Okay, you will get red color. Okay, but it does not form precipitate with your it does not form precipitate with BrCl2, but it will form some precipitate with, but it will forms, it will forms precipitate with what, beta? Yes, AgBr. It will form precipitate with AgBr and forming what? With, and forming with what? Then see here, when here AgBr will precipitate, when it will reacts with, when it will reacts with, when this reacts with whatever this complex reacts with AgNO3 solution. So from this data what we conclude, that yes, out of the coordination sphere your is what? Br. Okay, now see, we will now derive, don't worry, say now we will derive with the formulas and for better understanding. Okay, so you know this roughly idea about this ionization isomerism. Now we will do with the reaction, so then you will come to know easily what is actual happening in this ionization isomerism and how we can recognize this. Okay, so see here, in first we will write beta C as like this, CO Br NH3 5 SO4, means here whatever we want, either tetrahedral complex or either octahedral complex, it is fulfilling. Yes, see, total 5 and this one, means here octahedral geometry is fulfilling, so no issues. Now see, when it will reacts with BrCl2, so obviously what will form? BrSO4 as a precipitate. Okay, so here you will get like this, means it, how it will dissociate CoBrNH3 5 2 plus, because the SO4 having 2 minus charge, plus SO4 2 minus. Okay, or we can say what, it gives a taste of, it gives a taste of your sulfate ion here. Okay, understood. Now what will the ionizable part? Now see here, in next case what will happen? CO SO4 NH3-5, and out of the coordination there is a Br. When it reacts with urease NO3, you will get what? HBr as a precipitate. Okay? And you will get like this. Beta, see how COSO4 NH3-5 take a plus what your Br minus. It gives a test of what? It gives a positive test of your Br minus. So like that, see, when once your Br will outside, once your SO4 will outside, means these are what? These are what as an example of ionization isomerism. I hope you understood this case. Okay. Now we will discuss beta. Say, now we will discuss some another examples also regarding this. So pay attention. Okay. Pay attention on the another examples in your where? Yes. In your coordination sphere. Sorry, in your ionization isomerism. Okay. So say you can write another examples. Okay. Another examples of ionization is ionization isomerism. Okay. You can write here. Yes, see here. CO Cl2, okay, CO Cl2 NH3 2, okay, and outside the coordination sphere there is a NO2, and in next case what will happen? Yes, now this NO2 will inside and you will get what? Cl2 outside, as like this CO. See, your NO2 now inside, beta, okay, NO2, now here what? Yes, then NH3 NO2 over, now this Cl, okay, here what? NH3 4, okay, and outside what? Yes, Cl. May these are also what? Example of your, yes, examples of, not here 2 beta, here 4, means here also we have to fulfill octahedral geometry. So see, this 4 and this 2, 6, total is what your octahedral, means total 6 ligands, this 4 ligands and these 2 ligands. Okay, these are what? Out this ionization isomerism, here what? 4, 5 and 6, here also octahedral your geometry. Okay, now we will discuss here, you can write as a first. See beta, second examples you can write here PtCl2, okay, PtCl2 NH3 4, okay, here what? Br2, and now say here 4 ligands, here 2 ligands, so it also belongs to your octahedral geometry. Now in next case, yes, in next case what will happen? Okay, see what will happen in next is your Cl become what? Outside. So you may write here PtBr2 NH3 4 and Cl2 now out of the coordination sphere like that. So see here, this 4 and this 2, total 6 ligands are what? Forming. Means whatever either you have to form tetrahedral or octahedral, like that, these are what? Ionization isomerism examples. I hope you understood this. Okay. Once your NO2 inside, once your Cl outside, once your Br2 inside, once your Cl2 outside. So these are what? Example of your ionization isomerism. And when you are dealing with like that reagent, it will as a precipitate out. Okay. Now we will discuss here solvate or hydrate isomerism. See, now we will discuss what beta? Solvate. See here. Solvate. You can write solvate or hydrate isomerism. ठीक है, सॉल्वेट और हाइड्रेट आइसोमेरिज्म. नाउ बिफोर स्टार्टिंग यू कैन राइट हियर एज अ डेफिनेशन. सो से राइट द डेफिनेशन. द कंपाउंड्स विच हैव द सेम मॉलिक्यूल फॉर्मूला बट डिफर वेदर अ सॉल्वेंट मॉलिक्यूल इज देयर और नॉट. ओके, बट डिफर वेदर अ सॉल्वेंट मॉलिक्यूल इज देयर और नॉट. एंड दैट सॉल्वेंट मॉलिक्यूल here what? Solvate as a or hydrate means here water. Okay? It is also known as hydrate isomerism. Okay? Now here, the hydrate isomers, you can write beta. The hydrate isomers, okay? Differ in number of, yes, differ in number of water molecules present as a ligand as well as molecule of what beta? Hydration. Okay. Now here, one more important point here you have to mention. Whatever water molecule is either present inside or outside of the coordination sphere. Okay. It is, you have to write beta, most important thing. Say, water molecule is present inside or outside, okay, of the, yes, coordination sphere, okay, inside or outside of the coordination sphere, or we can say coordination entity. So examples you can write, say there are total three isomers having the molecular formula. We will mention here as an example, there are three isomers of molecular formula, having molecular formula. So say which are those that coordination compound? CrCl3.6H2O. Okay. So this we can written as in three types. Okay, so see here, concentrate on how we can write beta. Okay, say CrCl3H2O thrice. Okay, like that also we can write. Next we can mention here CrCl, not Cl2, CrCl, okay, H2O5 means our total six ligands are fulfilling here, this 1, 5 and this 6, like that, okay, and outside what? Cl2.H2O means now only, in first only we are told. Okay, whatever your water is as a ligands or as a molecule of hydration. So take care here. Okay, so see, third one you can write beta here. CrCl2, okay, then obviously how many H2 will come? 4, and whatever remain as like this, we can write, say total 3 are there. So this Cl2H2O. So like this we can write. Okay, so these are what your solvate or, yes, hydrate isomerism with examples. Okay, Now, see, they differ largely. So whatever we wrote here, formulae of hydrate isomerism, they are differ largely from one another in their physical and chemical properties. Okay, in their physical and chemical properties. Okay, now we will discuss here few more examples. Okay, see here, few more examples we can write for your hydrate or solvate isomerism. So ready with this, so you can write beta, CO, Cl, okay, En twice, okay, say here, CO, Cl, En twice, H2O, and out of the coordination sphere, there is a Cl2, means here, Cl, one ligand, these are bidentate ligand, there are two numbers, so 5 and 6, means our octahedral it is completed, okay, and you can mention here another also, COCl2, En2, okay, and Cl.H2, these are what, means, जिथे कुठे वॉटर मॉलिक्यूल आहेत कुठल्या कॉम्प्लेक्स मध्ये तर ते काय असणार तुमचे हायड्रेट और सॉल्वेट आयसोमेरिझम. कीप इन माइंड. ओके, सो सेकंड ऑल एग्जांपल ऑल्सो वी कॅन हियर मेन्शन बेटा, यू कॅन राईट COCl H2O, COCl H2O, दे गे वॉट, येस, NH3 4, ठीक आहे, Cl2. सो सी, 6 ligands are there, 4, 5 and 6 ligand, means our whatever we are writing chemical formula of that particular complex, it is correct. So see here, and we can mention COCl2, okay, sometimes beta they will ask question, okay, they will ask question on the basis of what? Identify which type of isomerism it is. They gave, if they are giving us different types of isomerism, and we have to identify what correct isomer type, okay, whether it is of solvate, ionization, linkage, coordination. Now we are discussing here, okay, so third hour is what, after solvate there is a coordination isomerism. What beta? Yes, coordination isomerism. Third, see, third is what? Coordination isomerism. Now see here, in coordination isomerism, what will happen? So we have to write first definition of this. The type of, it is what, the type of isomerism occurs in, it is a type of isomerism, okay, occurred in compounds, okay, containing both cationic and anionic part, means cationic and anionic, both positive and negative part, or we can say entities, and the isomers differ in distribution of ligands, and the isomers differs in distribution of what beta, ligands, okay, it is main important condition to whether it is belongs to coordination isomerism or not, okay, most of the part is for cationic and anionic. So we will write here examples. So be ready with examples here. ठीक है. So write बेटा examples. See. CO, that is cobalt, NH3 6. Okay, and here you may write CrCN6. Means obviously these are your positive part is what your anionic part we already discussed, and it differs in ligands also. Say different ligands. Here ammonia, here cyanide is ligand. So we can identify it belongs to what your coordination isomerism. Okay. Now on we can also mention another pair also on the base of this. Say CrNH3 6 and what? Yes, CoCN6. Okay. We can also write. These are first example, then second example. So say you can write second example also CuNH3 4. Okay, then PtCl 4. Cl different ligands also there. Okay, and obviously here what? Cationic and anionic part also there. So here what? PtNH3 4, and here what? Yes, CuCl 4. Okay, CuCl 4. In some cases your same also sometimes you will get ligands as like this. Okay, of same metal also it can happen. Okay, whatever in your, yes, coordination isomerism of that type also we can beta mention here, that is CrNH3 6, CrCN6. Understood? CrNH3 6, CrCN6. These are what? Different ligand, and also in that what? Cationic and anionic part. Okay, now we will discuss here linkage isomerism. Okay, linkage isomerism. Say in linkage fourth linkage isomerism. Okay, linkage isomerism. So what will happen in linkage isomerism? First we can write the compound having same molecular formula but differ in their properties. This thing you know, differ in their mode of attachment. Here what we can also say that differ in their mode of attachment. So basically in linkage isomerism we can directly mention how it belongs to what? Yes, ambidentate ligands. What beta? Ambidentate ligands. So as you know, ambidentate ligands, some are joined with NO2, then bond ONO, NC, CA, okay, HCN, then NCS. Okay, here these are what beta? Your examples of, yes, examples of what? Ambidentate ligands. You are observing, you know here names also of these ligands. NO2, that is nitrate OA, nitrate O, isocyanide, cyanide, thiocyanide, isothiocyanate. Okay, join through AN. Okay. Now see here, we can write here as an example. Okay, example of linkage isomerism. So concentrate on this example. CO ONO NH3 5, and here what? Cl2. Okay, so you can write beta here IUPAC name also. Okay, or you may write like this CONO2 NH3 5 and what Cl2. Means when you are like this, two isomers will come or different ambient ligand. At that time, surely it is what belongs to your, yes, belongs to your linkage isomerism. Means how we can identify? We can identify with your ambient ligand. Okay, I hope you understood this content regarding your what. First one is ionization, then coordination, then solvate hydrate, solvate or hydrate, then coordination, thereafter what? Fourth, linkage isomerism. So now you will come to know how we can identify this such type of examples regarding your this all structural isomerism complexes. You must know how we can draw. They can ask you have to draw any one type of isomerism among this, okay, or you have to identify which type of this compound will show isomerism. Okay, so see here we will discuss now our next, that is, as you know, stereoisomerism. Okay, this now we over our structural isomerism. Now we will discuss what stereoisomerism. So beta, concentrate on this part, that is, yes, stereoisomerism. Okay, stereoisomerism. Now what it is stereoisomerism? In that we are mainly discussing what already I told regarding stereoisomerism. There is a relative arrangement of groups, okay, or we can say special arrangement here. Now see, in that we will discuss first, we will concentrate on this geometrical, see beta, geometrical isomerism. We can call like this also GI, geometrical isomerism. Okay, now see, you can write geometrical isomerism arises due to different arrangement of ligands. Geometrical isomerisms arises due to different what? Yes beta, different arrangement of yes ligands. So as you know, monodentate, bidentate, okay, these are different arrangements of ligands we have to discuss here. Okay, around the different arrangement of ligands around the, yes, CMA. So CMA, you know, central metal atom. Okay, now we will discuss here one by one. Suppose beta, it is we will discuss here roughly one example. Suppose it is one of the complex M, and here at the one position there is a different ligands are there. One, okay, see, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now what will happen? As you know, geometrical isomerism, they are divided into further which type of isomerism, that you know better, because it is you studied first in organic chemistry, cis and trans. Okay, now among this, as you know, which are those cis isomers position and trans isomer position. So we can here mention beta for this type of complexes. Yes, cis are what? Yes, 1, 2 are cis. Then yes, 2 and 3 also 6. 3 and 4 also 6, and 1 and 4 also 6. Now suppose if you are discussing here trans, means same side, these are what? All are 6. Okay. And opposite side 2, 4. 2, 4 are trans, and here what? 1, 3 are trans. Opposites. These are same side. Trans are what? Opposite side. Okay. Now suppose we will discuss regarding as a in square planar complexes. Okay. Square planar this geometry. Suppose if you are discussing regarding you are, so we will discuss here only. See. Okay. In octahedral geometry, so what will happen? Say suppose here what beta? Here your center metal M. Okay. Here ligands are there, so we can directly give the names, numbers 1, 2, 3, okay, 4, 5, and 6. Now among these, whenever octahedral complexes are there, so at that time beta, how we can justify here whether your which isomers at what number cis isomers are present and at what number your trans isomers are present. So see here, it is very much easy. Now see, suppose it is a plane. Okay, so I will show you. Wait beta, see here. See, suppose if you are considering as a examples of your octahedral complexes. Okay. Now say this what beta, it is a plane in that 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. And these are 5, and suppose if you are considering like this. Okay. See, like this, if you are considering. So these are what? 5 and here what? 6. Understood? So like that only they gave 1, 2, 3, 4. Suppose if you are considering here as a 5 upside and upper side what? As a 6. Okay. Now see here. Suppose if you are here considering this as a 1. Okay. So with respect to 1, 6. Okay. Then here 2, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6, these are what? Say same side. These are what beta? Same side. At the same side, therefore these are what? All are 6 here. Suppose if you are considering as a downside. Okay, so downside, what will happen here? Yes. 1, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, and 4, 5. These are also with respect to these are what? As a cis. Now what will be the trans? Trans is what here? Yes. Trans is what? 5 and 6. These are what? Trans. I hope you wrote this. Okay. Okay. And another also we can mention beta here. Okay. With respect to 6 you wrote, with respect to 5 you wrote, okay. Now suppose if you are with respect to 1, 4, okay, then 3, 4, okay, 2, 3, 1, 2, so these are also what your cis position. Understood? I hope you understood this. Okay. Now see here, another also we can mention here. Yes, 1, 3 and 2, 4. So see, trans we can mention here. Yes, 1, 3, 2, 4, trans. Okay. And 5, 6. Other all. Now only I told that you have to write. 6 positions. Okay, so whatever 6 position you have to write beta with respect to 6, with respect to 5. Means with respect to 6 what? 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6. With respect to 5 what? All other. I hope you understood. You can write. Okay. Like that we discussed the what? Cis and trans isomers, possible isomers in square planar and in octahedral complexes. Beta, you have to mention here what are the number of cis isomer here and trans already I wrote. Like that I shown diagrammatically. Okay. Now here we will discuss geometrical isomerism in complex compound with coordination number 4. So are you ready with this?
Yes.
See, we will discuss geometrical isomerisms in compounds having coordination number 4. So be ready with this. Okay, see here beta, geometrical isomerism. So first we will discuss here with respect to coordination number 4. Okay, in coordination number 4, now in that first we will discuss regarding tetrahedral complexes. Regarding what beta? Yes, tetrahedral complexes. Okay, so you can draw here your tetrahedral complexes. Okay, see, in tetrahedral complexes, so see, tetrahedral complexes does not show GI. You can mention beta, tetrahedral complexes does not show GI, geometrical isomerism. Because why? Because all the four positions are what? Equivalent in tetrahedral geometry. Okay, understood. So suppose if you are considering here metal as A, okay, B, C and D, and suppose I will write in this fashion A, B, C and D, so nothing will change, therefore it does not show your GI, that is geometrical isomerism. Okay, so these are what regarding your in coordination number 4. First we discuss what? Tetrahedral complexes. Now we will discuss here, okay, in coordination number 4, that is second, square planar complexes. What beta? Yes, square planar complexes. So see here, what will happen in square planar complexes? Okay, in that we will discuss types. Okay, so in types, concentrate on these types. First type we will discuss MA4 type. What beta? MA4 type. Now here you know this, what is A, what is a in that, after that, afterwards we will discuss what is a B. Okay, so A, B, A, A. So see here, A is what? A is your monodentate ligands. Okay, now A, B is what? AB, you can mention beta, unsymmetrical bidentate ligand. ठीक है, AB is what? Unsymmetrical bidentate ligand. A, you can mention A here. A is what? Symmetrical bidentate ligand. Symmetrical bidentate ligand. So see here, symmetrical bidentate ligand. So in this case, we will mention beta examples also. A monodentate ligands, as you know, so many examples. Cl minus, your water, ammonia, cyanide, OH minus. These are what? Monodentate ligands, as you know beta. AB, yes, AB here, unsymmetrical bidentate ligand. In that, you can write as an example of DMG. DMG is what? Dimethyl glyoxime. Okay, dimethyl glyoxime. Okay, now in A symmetrical bidentate ligand, see here we can mention here example EN, OX, etc. EN, as you know, EN is what beta here? EN is your ethylene diamine. Okay, and here your OX is what? Yes, OX is your oxalate ion. Okay. C2O4 2-. ठीक है, नाउ हियर वी विल डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग टाइप लाइक दैट विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू मेटल. ओके, सो पे अटेंशन विथ दिस जी आई ज्योमेट्रिक आइसोमेरिज्म विथ कोऑर्डिनेशन नंबर 4. ओके, एंड अबाउट स्क्वायर प्लेनर कॉम्प्लेक्सेस. सो सी MA4 टाइप, सो वी विल डिस्कस here MA4 type. Suppose if you will draw here metal with such type of arrangement here A, 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 and A, so they can show GI. No, it will not show geometrical isomerism because all ligands are same. Okay, understood. Now see here, if any position will change, there is no effect on that particular complex. Okay, now see, suppose if you are considering here another type MA3B type, so any changes you will come to know M your metal A and B. And suppose in next case, if you wrote as like this, here B and here A and A. So any position changes, if you change the position, though any, we can differentiate with respect to GI. No, here also, what this complex is, means in under this type, they will not show your GI. Okay. Now see here, next MA2B2 type. Okay, so see here, we'll now discuss as like, suppose we draw here AA, BB. Okay, now suppose here if you draw like this, means here AA and here what? BB. So yes, we can differentiate. Okay, so these are what? AA on the opposite side, BB also opposite side. So these are trans, these are what? Similar side, cis. Okay, I hope you understood this. Okay, now see, suppose if you are considering MA2BC type. Okay, see, suppose if you are considering beta here MA2BC type, so see here any changes or they will show any what? They will show any geometrical isomerism, or they will try to acquire their position in ligands. We will see, we will discuss. Okay, suppose if you drawn like this, your metal as like this. Okay, suppose I will drawn here A, here B, here C. Yes, little bit is C with respect to A, and here is what? With respect to A is an opposite size. So we can call it as a what? Transisomer. Okay, transisomer. So here, you understood what is going on here. A4 type is what? A3, B type, whether they are showing or not. A2, B2, and what? A2, B, C. Okay. Now, further, we will discuss some type here. I hope you wrote, you are reviewing notes, you are consistently revising all our content of coordination compounds frequently. Each and every student, you can share, you can interact with subject teachers, okay? Then success is yours only, okay? Now suppose if you are considering as a type M, A, B, C, D. So what will happen in this case? We will draw here M, okay? A, B, C and D, suppose like that, if we will draw. Now what will happen? We can form another also, yes, we can change the positions of ligands here. Okay, A, C, B, D, yes or no, we can change. Okay, so see here, total how many isomers? A ki position humko constant rakhna hai. With respect to, we have to change others ligands. A here. So how many total isomers you will get? Yes, total 3 isomers you will get easily. Okay. I hope you understood this. Now we can mention here. Okay. With respect to same side as a cis and opposite side as a what? Trans. Now condition is the ligand must be what? As you know, we will discuss here next type after this M, A, B, C, D. So see here, M, A, B twice. M, A, B twice type we will discuss here. Okay, so see how we can represent as a with a glycine. With what, beta? Glycine, as a glycine. Like this, we can represent NH2, CH2, CO, VO. Okay, so here we are forming a complex as like this. Now here what? NH2. Now here CH2, C. Okay, here what, beta? O, and here your O. Okay? Now see here, I will show here, beta. PT, okay? NH2, CH2, C, O, VO, as like this. And suppose O, CO, CH2, NH2, as like this. Okay, see here, same side, cis, and either what? Opposite side. I hope you understood this. Trans and is what as a cis regarding in type A, maybe twice. Okay, unsymmetrical. Understood. So whatever our next part regarding what geometrical isomerism with respect to coordinates number 6, so that we will discuss in our next lecture. I hope you understood this all contained, today's content. Okay, so thank you very much. Take care and stay safe.